Just take a look at these brand new examples coming out of Sora. OpenAI has given a select group of artists access to Sora, and they've created some of the most mind-blowing examples that we've seen so far. In this video, we're going to break down these examples, explain what they teach us about the capabilities and limitations of Sora, and much, much more. So strap yourselves in, ladies and gentlemen, as we dive into the future of AI video together. So this has been released on the OpenAI website, and they have said that we have gained valuable feedback from the creative community, helping us to improve our model. So first up is Shy Kids. And let me remind you that everything seen here is created with AI. You can see what's fantastic is the dynamics of this man cycling, that the AI, that Sora, actually understands conceptually how a bicycle works. Now, this is a comical, surreal piece that is satirizing what it would be like to live with a balloon as a head. And you can see what's great about this is we've got a real consistency in the character, that it's maintaining the same size and color to the balloon of the head. There are some slight moments when the balloon does seem to change a little bit in tone and shape, oscillating between more circular and slightly more oval. See, here you can see very oval, and again more like a light bulb shape, and in this instance it's very much more circular. So there's some challenges with the continuity of this piece, but what it really demonstrates is not only the ability to create something that is both realistic and surreal, but it gives us a taste of what's possible to create a narrative. This was made by Shy Kids, who is based in Toronto, and they're a multimedia production company who used Sora for their short film about a balloon man. And we now have the ability to expand on stories we once thought impossible, shares the trio made up of Walter, Sydney, and Patrick. Walter, who directed Airhead, remarks that as great as Sora is at generating things that appear real, what excites us is its ability to make things that are totally surreal. A new era of abstract expressionism. I think this is a key component of understanding the potential of this medium, is that it's really only limited by your imagination. And that is what's really going to set people apart when using this tool. It's not just the execution of using the tool, but it's really, what is the concept? What is the conceptual piece that is going into this? And this is what Walter goes on to say. He says that people from all over the world, with stories ready to burst out of their chests, finally have the opportunity to show the world what's inside. And for me, this is a key when thinking about how to future-proof your skill set, your career, and your own journey. And that is to concentrate on the very elements of storytelling. What makes a compelling story? And how can we tell original and evocative stories with this medium? So I certainly recommend thinking about some of the architectural templates that exist within the fundamentals of storytelling. If you look at the book by Joseph Campbell, A Hero with a Thousand Faces, he breaks down how there is this very specific, consistent story that transcends cultures. It is the hero's journey about a protagonist leaving their home on a great adventure before returning back to the very same place. But they come back with a new understanding of the world. Next up, we have this piece by Paul Trillo. And Paul Trillo is a multidisciplinary artist, writer, and director whose work has earned accolades from outlets like the Rolling Stone and the New Yorker. Paul has garnered 19 Vimeo staff picks, an honor given to the best short films hosted on Vimeo. And he said that working with Sora is the first time I felt unchained as a filmmaker. He states, not restricted by time, money, other people's permission, I can ideate and experiment in bold and exciting ways. His experimental videos reflect this approach. Sora is at its most powerful when you're not replicating the old, but bringing to life new and impossible ideas. And in his surreal, beautiful piece, you get to see a whole host of interesting dynamics. It has a wonderful sense of dynamism with the camera moving rapidly from scene to scene while still maintaining some semblance of coherence in the worlds that it evokes. There are these quite psychedelic landscapes, that switch between a few different worlds, playing with the intricacies of perspective, shifting from almost drone-like shots to first-person documentary-style images. It gives the sense of being on a roller coaster through a multi-dimensional universe. And it certainly employs some interesting uses of Sora. One of the most eye-catching ways to implement video in AI is to use reflective materials. And you can certainly see this coming up with this man who is made of small mirrored panels. And what's wonderful about this is it accurately reflects the lights that are coming into the scene. So you have these shop lights, these harsh neon lights, and they're being picked up with a subtle hints and hues of yellow and blue. And I would like to talk a little bit about the beauty of the composition of this exact shot. We have the head that is wonderfully silhouetted onto the blue sky. And we also have the beauty of the color palettes that we have these very pale yellows and pale blues, which contrast wonderfully. It's a fantastic color palette to use, yellow and blue together, because they are at opposite ends of the light spectrum. It's interesting to note that AI still has some struggle in spelling. For example, these words here are not necessarily making much sense. You might say that the perspective is slightly exaggerated, but you could definitely get this effect with a more of a fisheye lens. But the movements of this character are beautiful, the way that he's dancing smoothly and silkily, that the joints are in the right place. And it's wonderful how it suddenly morphs into this disco ball, which is quite a surreal transition. Now, it's really wonderful to look at the speed of these drone shots, these rapidly moving camera shots, because there is a sense of speed, but also of consistency, that there is no degeneration in the elements here, even though the camera is moving with great velocity. And it's wonderful to note just how seamlessly they create these complex transitions. Now, here's another interesting thing just to point out about the intelligence of this tool. Because here, if you just pause this frame, you can see that we're going through a tunnel, but the way that the lights in the tunnel and the opening of the tunnel are placed are extremely intentional, because it hugely evokes the feeling of a face of two eyes and an upturned mouth, a sad mouth. And these really represent actually some of the kawaii faces used in Japanese animations. If we have a look here at these little kawaii faces, these are popular little faces that are seen a lot in Japanese illustrations, where they're often put on inanimate objects to give them friendliness. And it's very interesting to see this pulled out from this Sora example. I mean, this is no coincidence that there is a face. I mean, if you look in endless examples of human design, you will always see that faces are put in either very intentionally or more surreptitiously. I mean, you only have to look at the design of cars to see how much the fronts are designed to look like faces. I mean, look at this Ferrari. I mean, the eyes are menacing and the grill here looks so much like a mouth. It is undeniable that people are forming relationships as they personify and anthropomorphize objects and landscapes. Now, as we continue to go through the video, I would like to pay particular attention at how smooth the transitions are from room to room. And here we have a very disturbing collection of junk breakdancing. So let's move on to this example by Nick Cleverov, who is the creative director of a team called Native Foreign, a creative agency based in Los Angeles. They specialize in storytelling, motion, and title design, as well as generative AI workflows. Co-founder Nick Cleverov, who is using Sora to visualize concepts and rapidly iterate on creative for brand partners. He suggests that budgetary restraints no longer have to entirely shape the narrative of creativity. I'm one of those creatives that thinks in motion. So when I'm in Sora, it really feels like I can bring any idea to life. And what we're hearing here from Nick is he is speaking to the financial implications of Sora. It is hugely bringing down the cost of creating video, that you no longer have to shoot on location, and you can create realistic, beautiful concepts quickly, easily, and much more cheaply. And in his piece, we see some wonderful realistic shots of a watchmaker crafting some wild gadgetry, and here it breaks into a more of a film noir style, which certainly seems to play to the strengths of AI video right now. Certainly once you increase the contrast and reduce the saturation, as well as the natural surreal feel of film noir, it certainly shows the potential of building out complete films using Sora. And certainly film noir will be one of the most obvious genres to experiment with early on. As I was sitting there, I was thinking of my own film noir genre. It had been 10 years since I'd picked up a camera, but at last I was ready. Now here, just look at the light here coming in through the window. This sun ray is just absolutely beautifully illuminating half of the shot. But it's important to notice that Sora still has some way to go. If you look at the bicycle on the wall here, you can see that it is not entirely correct. It seems to be missing a seat and there's an extra wheel up here. It does not actually look like a fully functioning mechanism. But this is only something that if you stop, you pause, you really start to look at it. At first glance, it doesn't appear that there is anything wrong with this video. Now just look at this beautiful reflections of the metal here, and especially notice how the light refracts as the car moves in the water, because the reflections of the colors are what really gives Sora a sense of reality and cinematography. Just look at that. Just look at the glistening of the yellow. Beautiful. Now in this instance, we can see that it's actually very accurately been able to render some coherent text onto the can, showing the possibilities for integrating typography effectively inside of Sora. We've got it perfectly rendered, the words salt soda, in a very narrow sans serif font. It looks a little bit like Bebas New, though if you do look closer at the text at the bottom, you can see that it's fairly nonsensical. Now I have to say that it's fairly unclear exactly what the narrative of this piece is, but it does demonstrate some of the potential in different circumstances. Next up we have August Camp, who is an artist and musician. August Camp is a musician, researcher, creative activist, and multidisciplinary artist. And he says that Sora represents a real turning point for me as an artist, whose scope has always been limited by imagination, being at odds with means, she explains. Being able to build and iterate on cinematic visuals, this intuitively has opened up categorically new lanes of artistry to me. I truly cannot wait to see what other forms of storytelling will come into reach with the future of these tools. And here she is offering a call to arms for creatives, that this is an opportunity to achieve more with your imagination, that you are no longer limited by your means, by the resources and funds that you have available. And I certainly would love to echo this notion, that this is an opportunity to stand up, to be part of an incredible opportunity to be at the forefront of an emerging creative medium. I believe that we're incredibly lucky. It's very rare that you get to be alive and practicing as a creative when an entirely new medium presents itself, because it offers so much more opportunity to be original and to be new. That, for example, it's hard to do something incredibly original with an oil painting these days. That has been a medium that's been explored for hundreds of years. And it certainly presents more challenges in doing something that's really taking the medium to new levels. Whereas video is here, and there are so many emergent capabilities of applying this technology that it really excites me so much. I'm hugely passionate and feeling a great sense of inspiration every week that there is a new tool to explore, there is a new way to apply technology, and that you have the opportunity to combine different technologies in original ways. And this leads to a whole host of rapid developments in creative expression. So let's take a little closer look at her piece. It's got a wonderful color scheme, very consistent greens and blues here, which is a nice analogous color scheme, which means the colors are next to each other on the color wheel, so it means they're very complementary as well. This is a very good technique. It's a very sci-fi looking, quite abstract, psychedelic adventure. Lots of these seem to be taking psychedelic adventures to strange realms. It's also slightly disorientating. I think a lot of these are employing quite fast, distilted camera techniques. And it's interesting to see these alienating UIs developed from Sora, seeing what they're coming out with, and the way that they're animating, almost like After Effects, animations, title sequences, and the glyphs being designed. Now, just to take a quick pause to read some of the text, you can see once again, it looks fairly nonsensical, but I do admire the font design. It's almost like a early 90s style VHS font. And I doubt that internal memory resortical stelestion actually means anything logical, but if you're a hardware engineer and you would wish to denounce my reasoning, feel free. But I would imagine that August had very specifically asked for VHS style videos to be rendered inside of Sora. And it's quite wonderful to see the sort of consistent aesthetic that's being carried out through the whole of this video. I'm just comparing that to how all over the place this previous one by Nick Cleverov was, where we went from fisheye realism to film noir to sort of 3D abstract futurism, especially with this final psychedelic mushroom encounter. Whereas this piece by August, I really appreciate how she has maintained a consistent aesthetic through her work. Now let's move on to Josephine Miller and take a look at her example. Josephine Miller is the co-founder and creative director of London-based Aura Studio, specializing in the design of 3D visuals, augmented reality, and digital fashion. She says that Sora has opened up the potential to bring to life ideas I've had for years, ideas that were previously technically impossible, she states. The ability to rapidly conceptualize at such a high level of quality is not only challenging my creative process, but also helping me evolve in storytelling. It's enabling me to translate my imagination with fewer technical constraints. And I love these wonderful aquatic mermaid-like creatures swimming made of stained glass, and especially the composition of this piece where we've got this triptych, which is three equal parts being put together, and these wonderful imaginative fashion pieces of these reflective glass costumes. It's really beautiful. They're the way that the glass is moving is very organic. It's almost as if it's alive. It's like a living creature on the bodies of these individuals. And she's really played to the strengths of Sora here in a couple of ways. Firstly, water often looks fantastic. The reflections that are coming out of the water, especially look at this guy's head being reflected here into the surface of the water, as well as playing with glass and refractive materials. You can see that there is a slight transparency, allowing some of the light through and constantly changing the reflections. And this really plays to the strengths, the visual strengths of Sora, of using water, reflections, and transparent materials, as well as embodying something that would be perhaps technically possible, but extremely surreal. Obviously, they are breathing underwater, which is, unless they're holding their breath, people can hold their breath for a pretty long time. So I enjoy this piece a lot. Next up, we have Don Allen Stevenson III. And Don Allen III, what a name. I wish I was the second, Samson II of Kent. I think I will name my son, my firstborn son shall be Samson, little Sammy boy, Samson Jr. Well, he, dear Don III, was starting his career at DreamWorks Animation. He is a multidisciplinary creator, speaker, and consultant who collaborates with major tech and entertainment companies on mixed reality, virtual reality, and AI applications. And he says, for a long time, I've been making augmented reality hybrid creatures that I think would be fun combinations in my head. Now, I have a much easier way of prototyping the ideas before I fully build out the 3D characters to place in spatial computers. Don cites Sora's weirdness as its greatest strength. It's not bound by traditional laws of physics or conventions of thought. And he's really employed this weirdness into his example here, where we have a giraffe crossed with a flamingo, a whale crossed with an octopus. What's this one? This looks like it's almost like a bull crossed with a fly. Oh, this wonderful combination of the giraffe and the flamingo. I'd like a pet like this. Pigs that can fly. And wonderful crosses of different animals, really using the imagination of combining animals in original ways. Here we have a fish swimming like a sea snake, and this very surreal rabbit crossed with an armadillo. It's a lovely bunny being well protected. This is a horse crossed with a fly, actually. And the way that it moves is particularly interesting, that it's actually embodying the elegance and grace of a horse's movement with the body of a fly. And just to pause momentarily and examine the beauty of the wings here, just look at the veins, these almost effervescent, glowing wings are, they're like pieces of stained glass. Now here we have a kangaroo crossed with a reptile. And it's wonderful to see how Sora has taken these two animals and decided which parts of each to take and combine them. And I particularly appreciate that it's able to take two completely different animals, understand what they look like, and then come up with an idea of how to combine them. It's completely done this of its own accord, and it shows a sense of intelligence around that application. Also, the framing, the colors, and the camera composition is very reminiscent of a nature documentary here. It's really evoking that style. You can certainly imagine David Attenborough narrating on this. And here we have the rare and endangered Reptilius kangaroonus. Ah, and my favorite, the flying fox. An absolutely remarkable breed. An acknowledgement to Don Allen Stevenson III. You've done a wonderful job. Now, the next example is one that I'm incredibly excited about because it explores some of the emergent capabilities inside of Sora. And this talks to some of the possibilities of using this tool in unexpected ways. And this example shows the potential for working in 3D. Now, Alex Rebon is a sculptor artist and OpenAI's artist in residence. He spent the last decade creating work that explores the humor and absurdity of human nature in artificial intelligence. Alex has been creating sculptures that originate from AI-generated imagery, manually transforming those AI creations into 3D models materialized in the physical world. He says that my experience of using Sora was as a starting point to develop 3D sculpture. My thoughts drifted towards exploring the realm of photogrammetry, and its potential applications to sculpture. Now, I'm not entirely sure exactly what photogrammetry means, and I can tell you what it means is it's the science of making accurate measurements from photographs and using optics principles, the camera's interior structure, and its orientation to reconstruct dimensions and positions of objects from overlapping images. So essentially, it's taking film images, photographs, and extrapolating the data inside to create 3D models. Now, he said about Sora that my experience of using Sora was as a starting point to develop 3D sculpture. My thoughts drifted towards exploring the realm of photogrammetry, and the prospect of transforming video into 3D models intrigued me, as it hinted at propelling the AI system beyond its initial scope. So let's take a look at his work. And here you can see that he asked it to design a 3D render of a complex sculpture. And what he then did was use this to create 3D models of the sculptures. And it looks as if he's been experimenting in then rendering and manifesting these using possibly 3D printing techniques. So just pause it here. You can see here that we've got the AI video on the left-hand side from Sora. And on the right, you can see a computer program has picked up the points of reference and started to extrapolate a 3D model out of this. Now, OpenAI does also have a 3D generative model called Shapey, and it certainly has produced some rather rudimentary 3D models. Now, there is another example from Alexander Rebin where he's been able to take a video from Sora and turn it into a 3D scene. And it really shows that this technology is opening up more avenues for creativity, especially in the rendering of 3D environments and worlds. Now, Alex Rebin has some interesting other works on his YouTube channel. Be sure to check out some of his other experiments with AI and 3D creation. Now, we can expect that we're going to be getting technology like Sora becoming more accessible to the public in time. And every week, the available AI video generators are getting better and better. Now, one of the reasons we might not be seeing Sora in the hands of the public anytime soon is because of the huge amount of computing power that it needs to work. I found this study that said that we estimate that Sora can at most generate about 5 minutes of video per hour per NVIDIA H100 GPU. Compared to LLMs, inference for diffusion-based models like Sora is multiple orders of magnitude more expensive. And so what it's saying here is that it will take 1 hour with one super powerful NVIDIA computer to render out just 5 minutes of footage. So that's about 12 minutes per 1 minute of footage, which is quite a long time to be working with actually creating works, especially if you then want to make changes as you go. But there are going to be smaller and more compact models that are going to be available to the public. And one tool that I've been looking at in the last few days is Noisy. And they've actually got a tool that's allowing you to do prompt to entire video. And let me show you some of their examples coming through. All you have to do is submit a MP3 and it will create a music video for you with multiple different scenes. Here you can see one of a dog living his life. And it certainly showcases some of the possibilities of creating much longer, more complex works with simple inputs. So I will be doing a video explaining exactly how to use this and breaking down some more of their examples later this week. Now, I wanted to talk a little bit about the emergent capabilities that are presenting themselves inside of Sora. On the OpenAI website, tucked away on a research paper, they said that there is emerging simulation capabilities, and where they say that we find that video models exhibit a number of interesting emergent capabilities when trained at scale. These capabilities enable Sora to simulate some aspects of people, animals, and environments from the physical world. These properties emerge without any explicit inductive biases for 3D objects, etc. They are purely phenomena of scale. For example, 3D consistency. Sora can generate videos with dynamic camera motion. As the camera shifts and rotates, people and scene elements move consistently through three-dimensional space. Now, this is remarkable because Sora has some understanding of how a 3D world works purely through being trained on 2D data. So it's never been given an understanding of 3D reality. It's only ever seen 2D examples. And through that, it's been able to extrapolate and understand the mechanics and physics of our reality. And that is incredibly exciting. And recently on a podcast with Lex Fridman, OpenAI CEO Sam Altman had this exchange. First, Lex said that to represent that it has like a great underlying 3D model of the world is a little bit of a stretch. But if you can get there through just these kinds of two-dimensional training data approaches, Sam says it looks like this approach is going to go surprisingly far. And the key understanding here, the key piece of interest is how much of our reality can be understood through the patterns of 2D video? That Sora can understand how the world works by merely looking at sequential images. That is remarkable. And to illustrate this more, the fact that when something passes in front of another object, if it occludes another object, and the object remains in the background, as you can see, this dog remains no matter that these people are passing across, it really shows that there is some understanding of how the dog is in space compared to these people. And then the other interesting insights that Sora has developed is the fact that it can, for example, have a man eat a bite of a burger and that part of the burger disappear. It shows it understands to some degree how a burger relates to a human, that a human eats a burger and a piece of that burger will go into their system. Likewise with painting, you can see that this painter is leaving marks on the canvas that are realistic to how you would imagine an individual actually painting. So what are the most exciting possibilities of Sora, and what is the consensus of the artists that use Sora? It's not its ability to recreate the world as we know it, but actually to recreate things that are impossible to create and make them look real. So the ability to create special effects of alien or surreal situations is really where the capabilities of Sora and AI video shine. One of the artists goes on to say that Sora is at its most powerful when you're not replicating the old, but bringing to life new and impossible ideas we would otherwise never have the opportunity to see. Now, this is important because OpenAI is currently courting Hollywood and looking to get some deals set up so that large movie productions can start to use this technology. And that's going to be one of the early gateways of really applying AI video to real world situations. The Verge reported that OpenAI is pitching Sora to Hollywood. The AI company is scheduled to meet with a number of studios, talent agencies, and media executives in Los Angeles next week to discuss partnerships. Sources familiar with the matter tell Bloomberg. Although Sora is still awaiting a public release later this year, Bloomberg reports that a few A-list directors and actors have already been given access. And I think that's something we're going to see more and more of, as this is going to be slowly rolled out until it's accessible to the whole public. Now, we can see that there are four main trenches of use cases for AI video. This is obviously discussing the uses in traditional media for creating film and television shows and productions, and enhancing the ability to tell stories in a compelling way by creating realistic, mesmerizing special effects with a lower production cost. And it's really going to help democratize the nature of filmmaking. And we're going to see a huge explosion of amateur individuals having the same capabilities as huge Hollywood studios. I think it won't be long until we'll be seeing Oscars won by individual filmmakers. But beyond that, we're also going to be seeing this type of technology start to appear inside social media for creating content for YouTube, TikTok, and Instagram. So on channels like mine, we're going to start to leverage the abilities of AI video to create the footage inside of these films. Beyond that, there's going to be the corporate avenue for content creation and back office efficiencies for creating teaching and instructional content for large corporations. And of course, e-commerce with the ability to create realistic product advertisements and demonstrations. This will be a great way to show off physical products in different environments, different situations, and for creating a whole host of different advertisements. Now, we are expecting Tesora and other AI videos to advance in capabilities extremely rapidly. And we're going to look back at this year, 2024, as the year of AI video. And I, for one, am thrilled about what this has to offer creatives like you and me. And if you'd like to stay updated, make sure to subscribe to the channel. I've actually just changed the name of the channel to be a little bit more succinct and accurate to what we represent. Let me know what you think of the new name, AI Samson. I'm AI Samson here to give you the latest news on AI as we delve into the creative adventures that this new technology is offering us all. And I'm very open to any feedback that you might have on how to improve my videos, or if there's anything you'd like me to cover. And once more, thank you for watching. Thank you for being here. And most of all, I hope you have a delightful day.